after 44 overs. BBC News.
Hello, is this thing on? I'm told it is. This is Steve Wright. It's now my great honour to be continuing Paul Gambaccini's success as host of the awesome, the legendary Pick of the Pops. Now, as we start the show, the big question is, shall I say it? Shall I?
You should say it.
Yeah?
You should say it. Really?
You should say it.
Really?
Say it.
All right. Greetings, pop pickers. We're on our way. Get caught up in the rapture as we go back to the month that we first saw Thomas the Tank Engine, Arnie the Terminator, who said he'd be back, and he was. It's 1984. There's a song that goes, I just called to say I love you. And also, if there's something strange and it don't look good, who are you going to call? But we begin with number 19, down 6 from 13. It's U2 and Pride in the Name of Love. Welcome to the 21st of October, 1984. It's Pick of the Pops with Steve. And yes, staying close to the edge, you too. Pride in the Name of Love. Why does Bono wear dark glasses? Well, he's got a chronic eye condition. That means his eyes are light sensitive. That song, by the way, written in tribute to Martin Luther King. The UK chart from the 21st of October 1984 on Pick of the Pops, the year when the most popular car was a Ford Escort. You could only drive it if you're a rep, and of course you had your jacket on the back seat. At 18, it's the Stranglers with Skin Deep. At 17, it's the Big Guy in a Suit, the Eccentric Meatloaf with Modern Girl, and here comes number 16, Bronski Beat and Why. Hello, good afternoon, this is Radio 2. Gary and the producer, Deuce de Fruit. And they both stopped me singing along with the tunes. Well, we'll see how we go. That's Bronski Beat. And Why? The follow-up to Small Town Boy. Lead singer Jimmy Somerville would soon leave the band and form the Communards. Now, Pick of the Pops continues with Spandau Ballet and Highly Strung at 15. You'll know them, of course, as the band who used to dress themselves up to look like trussed-up chickens. They won't mind me saying that. They're over it now. Mix a song which you'll be sick of in a couple of weeks' time. At number 14, it's Ghostbusters with Ray Parker Jr. Halloween on the way. Who are you going to call? Ghostbusters.
I can't do it. Who you going to call?
Shouting loud enough.
Ghostbusters.
What's the matter with you?
Louder.
Louder?
Ghostbusters.
All right, friend, that's enough.
Who you going to call?
Ghostbusters, the movie, starred Dan Aykroyd and Bill Murray. Their mission to ban ghosts, including Slimer and Marshmallow Man. Coming up next at 13 on Pick of the Pops, the song that goes, that was great, adventure. Go on, Midge, get in. Superb tune on Pick of the Pops, Love's Great Adventure, Ultravox. If you listen very carefully, you can actually hear the kitchen sink in there too. Oh, but it's brilliant, it's brilliant. Love's Great Adventure's mine. Da-da-da. That's at 13. At 12, it's Julian Lennon, Too Late for Goodbyes. At 11, I'm going to tear your playhouse down, Paul Young. But that won't be necessary. Actually, I saw Paul Young recently. He is, of course, dashingly handsome. Got a velvet jacket, leather trousers. Look like a cross, actually, between Bill Clinton and Colonel Sanders. So he's at number 11. We're into the top 10 after this.
BBC Radio 2.
Playing the hits. Who's on top?
Pick up the pops. Pick up the pops. Pick up the pops. Pop, pop, pop.
Pick up the pops. Laughing Boy Paul Weller and the Style Council shout to the top, down 3 to number 10.
We're gonna shout to the top, shout. Ooh, we're gonna shout to the top.
show, by the way, is coming from BBC Maida Vale, and truthfully, I often see Paul Weller, not on his scooter, but just walking around this area. And I say, all right, and then he says, all right. That's the kind of relationship we've got. The Style Council and Shout to the Top. The Style Council were Paul Weller and Mick Talbot. The video featured paintings of the coal miners' strike from this year of 1984. And in the year 2000, it was also featured in the soundtrack to Billy Elliot. Now, here's a great song at number 9. It's John Waite and Missing You. Saturday afternoon, Radio 2. How you doing? This is Pick of the Pops. I know. Giving it a go. No matter. Missing You, John Waite, is at number 9 in our countdown. That's not the John Waite who won Bake Off in 2012, or the John Waite from Strictly, or the broadcaster John Waite from Radio 4. And it's not John Waite, the actor from The Waltons. Good night, John Boy. But the talented singer-songwriter John Waite, Missing You. It's down 1 to number 9. Now we hit number 8. It's Alison Moyer with the classic All Cried Out. Number 8, it's Alison Moyet with the classic All Cried Out. Just a word, if you're a fan of the 80s, you can hear Gambo and I next week on Sounds of the 80s with Gary Davis. He's also, of course, Gary, that is, on tonight at 8 o'clock or any time on BBC Sounds. So Alison Moyet, still very strong, great voice after 40 years and a brilliant talent. We're in October 1984 and this is Pick of the Pops, looking next at number 7. Peaking this year at number 5, it was to get a re-release next year, 1985, and topped out at number 4, following its use on Live Aid. And the profits from that re-release went to charity. The Cars Drive coming up.
BBC Radio.
In October 1973, I gave my first talk on BBC Radio 1.
50 years of Paul Gambaccini.
And I haven't changed a bit. I'll be sitting down with my old pal Steve Wright to look back at some of my most memorable moments.
Were you surprised at the quick acceptance you won in this country with the first single going to number 1?
It's wonderful, actually, how warmly I was received by the English people.
Radio 2 celebrates Paul Gambaccini's remarkable career.
We've had so much fun together, and I can't thank him enough for his contribution to radio.
Sunday night from 8 on BBC Radio 2.
Thank you. This is Steve Wright. We're at number 5 on Pick of the Pops. Now, I'm trying my very best to be tight and slick. Obviously, we're not there yet. And look, here comes Chaka Khan. A lot of people think that the harmonica solo in this is Larry Adler. But you'd be wrong. It's Stevie Wonder. I Feel For You, Chaka Khan, is heading for number 1, but the Queen of Funk is at number 5.
Chaka Khan. Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan.
Chaka Khan, I Feel For You, checks in at number 5. It would go on to be number 1 in 2 weeks and will stay there for 3. Now, let's look at number 4. It's Stevie Wonder, I Just Called To Say I Love You. Although it might not be his best ever song because Pastime Paradise is, and so is Do I Do. Unbelievably, though, this song to date is his best-selling single ever. It's from the movie Woman in Red. Stevie's big global hit is at number 4.
No New Year's Day.
You can do the da-da-da bit if you like. Stevie Wonder, I Just Called To Say I Love You. Stevie did say that he wasn't keen on the video, which you might remember was him singing into the phone. But it worked. The song was a hit all over the planet. We're into the top 3 now. This song is apparently about a love triangle between a man and a woman and a computer. A sort of early AI fusion. They don't just want our jobs, you know. It's Giorgia Moroder, Philip Oakey, number 3. Together in Electric Dreams. There, this is Steve Wright with Pick of the Pops. That's at number 3, Giorgio and Phil. Well, we'll take a break for news at 2 p.m, but first we're at number 2. It's Paul McCartney from the movie Give My Regards to Broad Street. Based around the old Broad Street railway station in the city of London in the 70s, as long before HS2. Some might say the movie was a bit of a misstep, but the soundtrack was a massive hit. from that movie. No More Lonely Nights, I Can't Wait Another Day.
I can wait another day.
Yes, Macca up to 2-2 before the number one for this week in 1984. Here comes the countdown. I have no idea if I can get through this, but we're going to give it a big try. Stand by. And yes, a number 20 down one, smooth operator, Sade. 19 down six, Pride in the Name of Love, it's you two. 18 down three, Skin Deep, The Stranglers. 17 up nine, Modern Girl, Meatloaf. 16 down five, Why Bronski Beat. 15 up 10, Highly Strung, Spandau Ballet. Down six at 14, Ghostbusters, Ray Parker Jr. 13 up 10, Love's Great Adventure, Ultravox. Too Late for Goodbyes, Julian Lennon is up 18 at 12. And then at 11, down two, I'm Gonna Tear Your Playhouse Down, it's Paul Young. Down three, Shout to the Top, The Style Council. At nine, up one, Missing You, John Waite. All Cried Out, up four, at number eight, it's Alison Moyet. And at seven, down one, Drive the Cars. Culture Club is there at number six, down three, it's The War Song. At number five, up 17, I Feel For You, Chaka Khan. At four, down two, I Just Called to Say I Love You, it's Stevie Wonder. At three, up two, Together in Electric Dreams, Georgia Moroder and Phil Oakey. And at two, up to No More Lonely Nights, Paul McCartney. It's the second of 3 weeks at the top of the chart. It's a great year for Wham. Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go has topped the charts earlier in the year, and George Michael had a solo number one in August. This week, Freedom is there at number one. Freedom is this week's number one, 1984. When we come back on Pick of the Pops, it's going to be 1990.
This is Radio 2
on BBC Sounds.
And on your smart speaker.
Play BBC Radio 2.
BBC News at 2 o'clock. This is Matthew Carter. It is 3 minutes past two.
Pick of the Pops. Hello, this is Steve, hour two. For this week, 21st of October 1990, second hour. I'm the fresh new host, Wrighty. And now it is 1990, the year of Beverly Hills 90210. A Mars bar was 27p. At the movies, it was Goodfellas. You think I'm funny? You think I'm funny? How funny? In this hour, a song that used to advertise Nivea. And there's Oi Wrighty. Got any crow? Yes, I do. And we kick off this 1990 hour with number 30 down nine places. Groovy Train, The Farm. Pick of the Pops 1990, Groovy Train. Which one would that be then? That's The Farm at number 30. Now, at 28, it's Groovies in the Heart by D-Light. The rap, by the way, provided by Q-Tip, and it's definitely to put in your ears. Here's Groovies in the Heart, coming.
Pick of the Pops on Radio 2.
We've no idea what's going on there. Dooster Fruit, the producer, said there is flashing images on this.
One, two, three.
It's radio. It's radio. But I did back off myself. At 20, it's Spin the Wheel. By the way, Groove is in the Heart is at number 28. At 20, it's Spin the Wheel. As I say, Turtles Get Real. High Tech featuring Yar Kid K. And if you've ever seen the video, it's three giant turtles dancing like they're on Strictly. Aztec Camera and Mick Jones are at number 19 with Good Morning Britain. Aztec Camera, of course, took their name from the failed 90s invention by Cadbury's, the first ever camera made out of chocolate. Sadly, it was discontinued, but the band done good. Now, at 18 down six places this week, it's A Shame, My Sister, Moni Love featuring True Image.
My sister, tell me what the trouble is.
We love that. Me, Gary and Dooster Fruit, we've left our soup to the end so we could hear it all the way through. Moni Love featuring True Image is at number 18, down six places this week. Well, it's Cliff at number 17 with a song written by Julie Gold in 1985. It was a hit for Bette Midler in 1990, one of the 68. These are just top 10 singles from Cliff. And by the way, he's about to go out on tour in the UK, starting at the London Apollo on November 6th this year. And here is Cliff from a distance at 17. Is Cliff Richard from a distance. Well, at 16, let's try it again. Didn't I blow your mind? New Kids on the Block, who are now Old Kids on the Block, singing songs like Quit Playing Board Games with My Retirement, Hanging Tough, Get Off My Lawn, or I'll Swish You with This Rake. And at 15, it's Hammer Time. Have You Seen Her? Can You Alter These Trousers? At 14, up 12 places, Belinda Carlisle, We Want the Same Thing. She was named after her mum's favourite film, Johnny Belinda, a 1948 movie. Rose to fame, of course, as the lead singer in the Go-Go's, who sold over 7 million records worldwide. Here she is solo at 14.
Hey! 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 Hey!
Yeah, that's a 14 on Pick of the Pops.
Oh, yes! Greetings, Pop Pickers!
Thank you. You've done that. At 13, it's Aha, Crying in the Rain. That's up six places. At number 12, it's Rita McNeil and Working Man. And at 11, I Can't Stand It, 24-7, featuring Captain Hollywood, who, by the way, was not a real captain.
Uh-huh. Pop-tacular, pop-pickers, pop-pop-pop, pick of the pops, let's have some fun, getting it done on a Saturday, pop-pickers, pop-tacular, getting the groove on Radio 2.
Okay, we're almost into the top 10 on Pick of the Pops. It's down five at 10. It's London B. I've Been Thinking About You. This is the first and last top 10 hit for the British-American group. Interesting factoid, in 1995, London B entered the UK heats for the Eurovision Song Contest with I'm Just Your Puppet on a String. No, no, not Muppet on a String, Puppet on a String. However, they were not selected to enter the main contest. It was a no. Thinking about you, yeah. London B, I've Been Thinking About You at number 10. Technotronic, Megamix at number 9. Now it's back to the movies at number 8 from Top Gun. It's Take My Breath Away. Some dialogue from the film, by the way, includes son, your ego is writing checks your body can't cash. And there's also another piece of dialogue. Excuse me, Mr. Maverick, how fast does this thing go? Number 8. It's Berlin, Take My Breath Away. And at number 7, it's Whitney Houston coming. Next year, 1991, Whitney will top the charts with Dolly Parton's I Will Always Love You. But up 9 to 7, it's I'll Be Your Baby Tonight. It's coming next. It's one of those tunes that cuts through, you know what I mean? Number 7. For this week in 1990, I'm Your Baby Tonight, Whitney Houston. Next, we've got a question for you. Why is a song written in 1950 that was a hit for Tony Bennett in 1951 on the charts in 1990? The answer is because it appeared in an advert for Nivea, you know, the moisturiser. Bobby Vinton topped the charts in the US with this song in 1963. And here it is, a hit all over again in 1990. At 6, it's Blue Velvet. Look at your lovely skin. Whenever I hear the phrase Blue Velvet, I think of Austin Powers. Yeah, baby. That's Blue Velvet, Bobby Vinton at number 6. Of course, also in the movie Blue Velvet.
It's on Radio 2. Pick up the Pops. Pick up the Pops.
BBC Radio 2.
And yes, we're into the top 5 with Happy Mondays and Kinky Afro. It was due to be called Groovy Afro, but they changed the name following the farm releasing Groovy Train. Fair enough. They'll be touring the UK again in March. Here's the Mondays at number 5.
Soon I'm 13.
Big goes Bez and his mates. Number 5, Kinky Afro, Happy Mondays. Well, we're down to number 4 on our chart, and here comes the first half of one of two medley songs released this year by Status Quo. The Quo were to enter the Guinness Book of Records in 1991 after playing 4 venues in one day. Sheffield International Centre, Glasgow Scottish Exhibition and Conference Centre, also the Birmingham National Exhibition Centre and Wembley Arena. Who doesn't love The Quo? They're at number 4, the Anniversary Waltz. That's fantastic. At 4, it's The Quo. And we're into the top 3 next.
Across the nation, this is Pick Up the Pops. Steve Wright. On BBC Radio 2. And on BBC Selves.
Here comes Unchained Melody next to The Righteous Brothers, written for the 1955 prison film Unchained, hence the name. The song, made famous in 1965 by The Righteous Brothers, was re-released in 1990 due to being included in the film Ghost. Oh, Unchained Melody, The Righteous Brothers. At number 3, from the movie Ghost, that's where I learned all of my pottery. At number 2, Maria McKee. There she goes, it's Maria McKee. At number 2, Show Me Heaven. Here comes the top 20 from the week of October 21st, 1990. Stand by. I've got some fast talking to do. At number 20, down 5, Spin the Wheel, Turtles Get Real, High Tech featuring Yarkid K. At 19, up 4, Good Morning Britain, Aztec Camera with Mick Jones. At 18, down 6, It's a Shame My Sister, Moni Love and True Image. Down to 17, and it's down 6, From a Distance, Cliff Richard. 16, down 8, Let's Try It Again, Didn't I Blow Your Mind, New Kids on the Block. At 15, down 5, Have You Seen Her, MC Hammer. At 14, up 12, We Want the Same Thing, Belinda Carlisle. At 13, up 6, Crying in the Rain, It's a Heart. Number 12, up 12, Working Man, Rita McNeil. At 11, down 4, I Can't Stand It, 24-7, featuring Captain Hollywood. Not a real captain. At number 10, down 5, I've Been Thinking About You, London Beat. Down 3, at 9, Megamix, Technotronic. Up 19 places, Take My Breath Away, Berlin, that's at number 8. And up 9 places, I'm Your Baby Tonight, Whitney Houston. Look, it's exciting. We're into the top 6. At number 6, down 3, Blue Velvet, Bobby Vinton. Up 15, at 5, Kinky Afro, Happy Mondays. At 4, down 2, The Anniversary Waltz, Status Quo. New at 3 is Unchained Melody, The Righteous Brothers. And down 1, Show Me Heaven. At 2, it's Maria McKee. And this week's number 1, up 3, A Little Time, here's The Beautiful South. Yeah, this week's number 1 is A Little Time by The Beautiful South. Gotta go. Thanks for listening. I don't expect a good review. Just give me some time. Thank you to producer Tom DeCrow, otherwise known as Deuce to Fruit. Studio manager Gary Parker. Very nice job. I'm back tomorrow morning for Love Songs at 9 a.m. And don't forget about Love Songs Extra on BBC Sounds. Thank you. And tune in next week for memories and the hits from 1967 and 1979. Pick of the Pops is a 7 digital production. Laters.
This is Radio 2.
On BBC Sounds.
And on your smart speaker.
Play BBC Radio 2.
BBC News at 3 o'clock. This is Anthony Birchley.